Okay, I'm gonna pack my suit. That's your bottle, not my bottle. Get out of here. No, it's not. No. Okay. Woo! This is so fun. This is so fun. Mommy. Yes, sweetie. Can I have my backpack? Yes. Michael Prozemanchikov's brokerage license. Take it off me. Okay, let me take it off. Okay. Law enforcement theorized that Michael may have been targeted because he was a Russian immigrant. So they urged caution. I see what's like this. Like, oh my God! Oh my God! Look at me. The word is that you're a friend of his. Whoever did this. Sweetie. Oh, there he is. I didn't see him. Wait, are you? I got the backpack. Look at me, backpack guy. That's like a little sneaker. XOXO. And you know what I have inside of it? I have this little. It's like you can type in it. Tap, 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 tap. I don't have my cousin here, Bernie, today. Not sorry. Okay. I'm gonna put that in my suitcase. And get me my suitcase, get it sucked up, get it ready to go with my backpack. I'm gonna put my backpack on mine. I'm gonna get my car ready. Boom, 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 boom. Okay. Here we get the stuff in. Okay, we're gonna get in now. Here we go.
All of these benefits and more, including plans that may help you keep your doctor and save money. Annual Medicare enrollment deadline coming. Don't wait another minute not knowing if you have the right Medicare fit. Having helped enroll people in millions of policies with an A-plus customer satisfaction rating, you can trust Health Market.
Don't assume that your plan is still the right fit. The Health Market Fit Score
makes it easy to find the right Medicare fit for you.
Health Market doesn't just work for one insurance company. They work to help you do it all quickly.
Your insurance marketplace, Health Market.
There may be Medicare benefits and savings, but missing out on them. Says the free Fit Score. Call 800-329-6800 before the deadline. That's 800-329-6800.
If you're looking for the best place to pick up a pizza, might we recommend the place with pizza in the name? Call Pizza Hut now to pick up a large three-topping pizza for just $7.99. No one out-pizzas the Hut.
Okay, I'm back. I need to text my mom.
Everyone makes mistakes.
The black one that I should.
But what if life was as forgiving as the general? You're in. At the general, we'll cover you.
Hey, Mom. Who is your record? Oh, yeah. I'm just doing my film on my camera. Yes. Now I'm gonna
In the search for Michael Prozemanchikov's killer.
I'm probably gonna get a stand for
suspects. Although Michael made a lot of money for himself as a stockbroker, not all of his clients liked the way he did it.
Zena Sherrill says she gave Michael $20,000, but told him to invest only in stocks that she chose.
I came to him and I said, "This is the deal. You do not touch it. This is whatever you do what I tell you not to do." He said, "Yes."
Almost immediately, Zena realized Michael was buying and selling stocks in her account without her permission.
I had a bill from the company that I owe them almost like $8,000 or $10,000 for commission buying and selling. So I went to his company and I said, Mike, look, this is for me.
In the brokerage business, that's called churning the account. Buying and selling stocks in a customer's portfolio for the sole purpose of generating commissions. Other clients allege that Michael promised returns of 18% a year in order to get their business, a practice that's illegal in many states.
Michael, he crossed a lot of bridges. A lot of illegal things.
Investigators also learned that Michael didn't always pick good stocks. For example, he bought shares in Texas Air for many of his clients at $48 per share. In a matter of weeks, it fell to $15.
My pay!
Most of the people we had talked to that had lost money were really not that upset that Michael had disappeared or that he had been murdered.
Look at me!
We even had several people that said they wish they could have done it.
On the night Michael was reported missing, his wife said he called her around 8:30. He said he was with a client and was working late. She also said Michael asked her for his supervisor's home telephone number.
In phone calls to his wife that night, he spoke Russian, which she considered unusual. Michael did not like to speak Russian in front of American clients. He considered it rude.
He would only speak Russian in front of some other Russian. She just assumed that whoever he was some other Russian.
Anybody, I had to put my legs on top.
Later, Michael called his boss at home
every day
with an unusual request.
He was asking for money, $200,000, and he said he needed to raise for a client that night.
Hello, guys.
This, of course, put everyone on their guard, because to get a call from a broker at night seeking $200,000 is highly unusual.
Michael said his client was leaving town early that day and needed the money immediately. Naturally, Michael's boss said no.
He just said, it's not that we're unwilling to come up with the $200,000, but we certainly aren't going to be able to come with it tonight.
And Michael's boss said that he made a strange reference to a boat.
What he said was, didn't you tell me that your father gave you $200,000 to buy a boat, to help you buy a boat? Well, his supervisor hadn't told him anything like that. And his supervisor later concluded and later told the police that he suspected that Michael was trying to send an alarm of some kind by reminding him of a conversation that never happened.
Bye, guys. I believe you. But I'll keep it on hold for a minute while I was my mother. Mom, can you get over your jacket a little bit? That's some.